Well, the sun is set on the 33rd Olympiad, which came to a close today with the closing ceremonies in France. Let's take a look at the major headlines surrounding the end of the 2024 Olympic Games. We're going to do it with a fantastic TV host and sports commentator who has joined us throughout these games, the one and only Julia Sun. Julia, what's
good
going on?
Good to see you. So many things going on.
Did you watch
the basketball games? I bet you did.
If you don't notice about me, I am a basketball junkie. So you know I watched the games. We texted during that. That was a fantastic finish.
This is what I like about sports. You never know.
You never know
until the last minute, last second. I know we can talk about, oh, let's preview this game. Let's preview the other game. We could be wrong. I think our odds are better than flipping a coin, but we could still be wrong and things could still twist and change and things happen. That's the beauty about sports.
That is the beauty of sports, and this is why you play the game. So we're talking about basketball, and basketball took center stage this past weekend, where both the men's and the women's side, it was USA versus France in the gold medal games. And Julia, we got ourselves two classic games. So the United States had come out on top in both of these games. For the men, their fifth consecutive gold medal in the Olympics. But for the women, it's their eighth consecutive gold medal, including 61 straight victories. We know this. The competition has gotten better across the world. So how impressed are you with what both teams accomplished here in Paris?
Well, let's say on the scale of from 1 to 10, we should be at an 11. They are just fantastic. I know the expectation was both of these teams was going to win, but they had a hard fight. But they still pulled through. That's awesome. That's what Team USA is about. You still fight for it when things don't necessarily go your way. Let's start on the men's side. Curry, just stellar resume, top to bottom. He didn't have to play like that, but he went nuclear, and then he delivered. Everything was just so fun to watch, and you're absolutely right. Instant classic game. I want to watch it next year, the year after. I'm going to refer back to this game in the years to come. It's just one of those things, and it's fantastic game for Curry. It's hard to believe that 2024 was actually his first Olympic appearance. I know it's a fact, but over the years, sometimes I ask myself, like, really? Is that the case? I know he missed out on the previous game because of personal reasons, and then Tokyo was more like a throwaway, so he wasn't there. And then back in 2012, he wasn't really at the Hall of Fame level, Curry. Now he is, and he will be forever remembered as the best shooter. He will be forever be remembered as one of the best players of all time. And I think by now, we all know how it feels to be a Warriors fan.
Oh, yeah.
For him. I adore the way he hugged Coach Steve Kerr after the game.
You see how much it meant to both of them.
How much it meant to both of them and how much relief they felt. Collectively, they said this. It's such relief. Yes, the expectation was they were going to win, but it's a different ball game once you get it done.
Oh, yeah.
Like, we did it instead of, oh, we are going to do it. That's a different feeling. The relief was there. And then on the women's side.
For the women, yep.
Oh, my God. we didn't know until the very last second what was going to happen. Right? Was it going to continue? Was it done? Like, we just didn't know. And what I think what makes Team USA stand out so much is, and I'm sure you saw this, as have I, is there were 50-something seconds left on the clock. Everybody was tensing up, but the expression on Team USA players' faces, it was one of calmness.
Mm. Yeah, that's what I saw too. You saw that. That's the experience. But there also was a lot of pressure on them, right? Because you're trying to keep this streak going.
Yeah.
They did do it. Now 61 straight wins. Yeah. But France gave them all they had, but those ladies came through in the end, and it was a fantastic performance.
Yeah, I want to give a shout-out to everybody who played on the opposing team.
Yeah.
Right? Victor Wembanyama, he was as good as anybody else.
Yeah, he was tremendous.
Yeah, and Gabby Williams, UConn, UConn star, as good as anybody else. But Team USA pulled through. Congratulations, Team USA.
Congratulations, Team USA. Very impressive in what we saw with the basketball. Now I'm going to move on to track and field because that's always one of the most watched sports at these games. We saw some incredible performances from Team USA. Okay, Noah Lyles winning the men's 100-meter dash. I know some people are going to talk about he only won it but who cares? He won. Yeah. The women's 4x100 final. Women get gold there. But there was some disappointment because we saw Lyles only get the bronze. In the 200, he was battling COVID, and Sha'Carri Richardson only gets the silver in the 100. What do you make of what we saw from United States track in Paris?
Well, overall, I think the U.S. track and field team had an incredible showing. This was their best finish since 1984. 34 medals, including, what, 16 gold medals? That's nothing to be ashamed
about.
Nothing
at all.
Right? Yes, there were mishaps. You know, was I a little bit upset? Yes, I was. You know, there were some problems with some of the exchanges, and we lost some medals here and there. But they did really well overall. For Noah and Sha'Carri themselves, however, that's a different story altogether. I don't think they necessarily walked away with the medal they wanted. For Noah, he was a favorite to win the 200 meter because he was a world champion that event multiple times too. And he was the favorite going into the games to win that. Instead, he won the 100 meter, which is not bad, especially with that photo finish.
Oh yeah.
I love that photo finish. It's really not a bad ending, and he can call himself a gold medalist, no doubt about that. With Sha'Carri, well, this whole trip is about redemption for her. I mean, she wanted that gold in the 100 meter because she did so well during the U.S. Olympic trial. Her time was 10.71 seconds. That was world record. She's a world record holder. And the person who beat her at the Olympics clocked 10.72. It's just she wasn't able to repeat her performance. I mean, that happens sometimes. It was just not the day. I think she should be proud of herself anyway. And let's remember, she's not done.
No.
She can try again in four years.
Yeah, and we expect both of them, Lyles and Richardson, to be back in 2028 in L.A. We'll get more to that later. But we'll move over to gymnastics because days after gymnastics was over at these games, there's now controversy, and it's surrounding Jordan Chiles because the IOC is taking away her bronze medal in floor exercise. Here's the cliff notes. I want to break down for people what happened, okay? Chiles' coaches appealed her floor exercises score because the difficulty level was incorrectly calculated. Then the judges agreed and gave her an extra tenth of a point, boosted her score to a bronze. 5 days later, folks, the appeal was voided by an IOC court ruling because it wasn't filed within a minute. Now, get this. It was filed in 64 seconds, so 4 seconds after a minute. Julia, take all that in. What do you make of what happened here with Chiles? Should she have to give her medal back, which the IOC courts has ruled that she does?
Well, I think the IOC should just give out 2 bronze medals and call it a day. I don't think she should give back her medal, but it's also not up to her.
We're talking about 4 seconds here. It depends on what kind of person you are. Does that matter here? Are you like, hey, these are the rules. It's a minute. You got to get it within a minute. They didn't do the appeal. We're talking about 4 seconds. I feel like I'm Allen Iverson saying we're talking about practice.
Right.
We're talking about 4 seconds here.
Yeah, it matters in their book. But my problem with this whole controversy is not really about the 4 seconds. I mean, it is about the 4 seconds, but it's about why flip-flopping. How come out of all the people on the judging panel, all the officials, all the experts, everybody who supposedly have worked in this sport or competed in this sport, nobody pointed this out on the spot?
Right.
Why?
It's a fair question.
Yeah. I mean, look, to a great cliff note, by the way, to add on to your cliff note, this appeal process had always been there. It's always available to the athletes if you think, oh, well, I have not been properly scored. If your coach thinks, oh, maybe they misjudged an element. Yes, you can pay a fee and then request a rescore. And yes, the judging panel would reevaluate. They could keep the original score or they could give you a different score, which could be lower.
Or higher.
Yeah, you don't know, but so they want to make sure when you appeal, okay, do you really want to appeal? And in this case, she did. Which is fine because that avenue has always been there. My problem is, okay, because this has always been around, how come nobody caught it on the spot?
Right.
Why let the athletes, both athletes, to go through this ordeal, this horrific ordeal?
Right, and the problematic thing, I agree with everything you said there, and the problematic thing as well is the fact that it's 5 days between this, and now we're talking about 5 days and 4 seconds, and you had the elation of winning a medal at the Olympics and then it's taken away. And if you're the person who then gets the medal because you're stripping it away from Jordan Chiles, do you really want, want to win the bronze?
To me, this is not a fight or a competition between Jordan and Anna. It's not even between America and Romania. It's a competition between the people who care about the athlete's well-being versus people who are not that responsible.
I agree.
Yeah, and look what kind of example this sets for all the younger athletes who are training on the junior level, and they will be seniors one day. Mm-hmm. I bet some of them are thinking, well, do I want to play the sport? I want to go to another sport or get out of sports altogether?
Or do I even want to go to through an appeal process and then have this same thing happen to me?
Because sometimes, yes, mistakes can be made, but you correct it immediately.
Right. And I don't think we should have it come down to 4 seconds.
To answer your question, I don't think she should give back her medal. It's not up to her. I think the least the IOC can do at this point is to give out 2 bronze medals.
I don't think that would be unfair at all. I'm with you on that. Last thing, on a business note, because this is what you like to talk about around sports, and that's this part of your bag. I saw this rather interesting story where the Summer Olympics caused travel to Paris to plummet, right? Delta Airlines alone, they expect upwards of $100 million in missed ticket sales as a direct result of the game. So why did these airlines lose money during these games?
It's because business travelers and tourists who are not that into sports tend to avoid a destination when there is a large-scale global sporting event in town.
So people are like, no, I don't want any parts of this.
Yeah,
I don't want to be
here. I want to avoid the crowds. I don't want to get stuck in traffic. Let's just not deal with the congestion. If I don't have to be there, I don't want to be there.
I can understand.
Yeah, that's the simple explanation. Why business travelers in particular? Business travelers are essential, more than essential, for airlines. Usually for a typical airline or on a typical flight, 12% of the travelers are business travelers. So 1 in 8, approximately. However, these travelers, they account for about 75% of the profits.
That's a lot.
Yeah, why? Because they're business travelers. You can swipe your corporate credit card, and a lot of cases you have to be there. Some people book their tickets last minute, and you know prices shoot way up. For example, if your TV station sends you to cover the Super Bowl, you're gonna get there. And maybe they'll give you a first class ticket so you can look great on camera the next day. So there is that leniency. There is that little leeway when purchasing business travel, business tickets. And they also tend to buy certain premium services. That's why they account for roughly 75%. So with the Olympics happening in a global hub destination, a popular tourist destination such as Paris, London, and to a lesser extent, I would say Atlanta, yes, people avoid that area until the games are done.
They don't have to deal with all the madness that comes around. Yeah. That makes sense from a financial standpoint. Yeah. On that, real quick before we go, I think one of the things you always keep an eye on with the Olympics, right, is viewership and people being tuned in. Felt, at least to me on social media, a lot of excitement around these games. Did that translate to viewers watching these
Olympic
games?
It did. And let me just first by saying I love when people watch more sports.
Yes, I love it too.
Sports are the best. So for the Paris Olympics, this is the number I got from NBC. Because they have some of the exclusive rights broadcasting in the United States. Their primetime viewership, 34 million on average. It's a lot. So that's 79% higher than their viewership 3 years ago for the Tokyo Games. Yes, people are watching more sports.
That is beautiful, and those great numbers for NBC. You got to be happy. A lot of eyeballs watching the Olympics.
Yeah, so to give everybody another way to make sense of this number, that's better than a regular season NFL game.
Yeah, and the NFL gets a lot of eyeballs.
Yeah, it gets, you know, not Super Bowl level, because Super Bowl is the most viewed sporting event in America, period. But it's somewhere in between there. It's in the same ballpark, and that speaks volume.
Yeah, that speaks a lot of volumes. Fantastic stuff there. Fantastic times talking Olympics with you throughout these games. It's been a whole lot of fun. I know you enjoyed it. I enjoyed watching. And we'll be talking a lot more about it. Check out Julia Sun and her fantastic work as a TV host and sports commentator. She does a great job talking about the business of sports. Julia, great to connect you in the Olympic Games. We'll do some more soon, okay?
Yeah.
All right. Sounds good. Thank you.